Good evening. I'm Amy E. Goodman, longtime friend of the McLean Project for the Arts and of Lori.
And I'm Lori Carboneau, Executive Director of McLean Project for the Arts. On behalf of the MPA Board, MPA Advisory Board, my colleagues, and our teaching faculty, it is my pleasure to welcome you to this exciting evening of our very first virtual benefit gala.
We are joining you live from the Emerson Gallery at the McLean Community Center, where our current exhibition is on view. MPA has placed safety first throughout this pandemic, and that continues with this event. We are obviously virtual for our audience, and both Lori and I took COVID tests in order to be together tonight.
This evening is dedicated to the power of art and community. We're in the midst of a moment where creativity, ingenuity, and resilience have been asked of each and every one of us. As we celebrate the McLean Project for the Arts and make history for the organization with this, our first ever virtual gala, we are delighted to have so many friends joining us.
Yes, the leadership and generosity of our community, including each of you in attendance, has helped build and shape what we are today. This excellent build over the last 59 years through our exhibitions, programs, and outreach across the region has made NPA a regional treasure. Tonight is going to be special, it's going to be fun, and it's going to be a success with your support. So far, we've raised a good amount of money towards our goal to surpass $250,000, of course, with your help. So let's jump in and start by learning more about MPA and the incredible impact of the organization.
Art will always be important to human beings. Art teaches us who we are, teaches us about ourselves, but it also teaches us about our connections to others. Art is constantly changing. It's a reflection of everything that's happening all around us, and you have to be able to change with it. You have to keep moving.
There's lots of magic in McLean Project for the Arts. We're a 60-year-old, robust, nonprofit community arts organization.
Space is everything, and we have beautiful spaces here. It's really an experience.
Our atrium gallery is perfect for a one-person show. It's intimate, you can get very close with the work, and then that opens up into this expansive space, which is one of the most beloved exhibition spaces in the region. It's bright, it's light, and what I think you get first is the warmth. We also have on site the spectacular Duval Studio, which shares those concepts of light and height, very high ceilings, and it's a marvelous place for instruction.
Our mission is to show contemporary art from the Mid-Atlantic region. Contemporary art is art made by artists today, and artists today who are working within the canon of art history and moving forward with their ideas to express what's going on now, both in art and personally. We look to represent lots of different styles, lots of different approaches, lots of different mediums. The women who founded MPA wanted to bring in interesting art and challenging art from outside the community to help educate and help local audiences grow. I think that is what made MPA what MPA is. It allowed us to become something kind of deep and more.
We're deliberate about thinking about ourselves as a venue for and a vehicle for conversation, engagement on topics that are nonpartisan, topics that are core to our heart. Exhibition and education can be thought of as the chambers of the heart. They work together, they are dependent upon each other, and they are existentially the same. An artist is learning as they are doing. A student is learning as they are doing. They are learning to make it, they are learning from making it.
Artists tend to work alone in their studios. At some point, it's not just about expression, it's about communication. The artist lets it go, and we take it in, and we put it in a different context. The work takes on its own life.
The rest of us who witness it have the opportunity to learn and grow.
Visual artists need to look for community, and a place like MPA offers community.
Looking at how the world was changing last March, we knew we needed to be there, be supportive for the community at large. Art gives each of us resilience. I found myself taking watercolor classes through the course of the pandemic. I painted a watercolor of my hand and gave it to my dad, I might get teary, for Father's Day, right? And so it was just this lovely personal touch when touch wasn't possible. The numbers of artists applying for our exhibitions more than doubled. The number of attendees to our openings, even though they've been virtual, have more than tripled. And the number of participants in our outreach program has increased by more than 500%. So it is playing out in the numbers how important art is. That MPA is an artistic home is a truism on many levels. We've shown the work of more than 3,000 artists over our 60 years. We are thrilled to be operating in the health that we are. So much of that is due to our board of directors and our advisory board.
We are always looking for new ways at MPA to help audiences get engaged with the space. You're always having to reinvent yourself. Over the years, we have really grown programming to be adaptive. We are going to be flexible and keep developing programming around our exhibits and around our educational programs to meet the needs of the current day.
The entire environment is a work of art. I truly believe that as a community arts organization, we should understand ourselves as a source of joy. It's a great place to come and learn from professional curators who are building a body of knowledge to inform the human spirit.
Wow, Lori, I am continually amazed by the extraordinary work of MPA. I'm inspired tonight by how your team and the entire NPA community have embraced this virtual gala. Really, far from driving us apart, this last year of physical distancing has shown us something profound and moving about ourselves, our fond and deeply felt wish to be connected with one another. That connection is real tonight, as we are welcoming so many attendees to the virtual gala, and is deeply evident in how the organization thrives with such amazing artists and arts faculty, mm-hmm. our deeply engaged board and advisory board members, and our committed staff leadership.
Amy, we're filled with gratitude for the strong support from our donors and supporters, from Arts Fairfax and the Virginia Commission for the Arts, along with Fairfax County and the McLean Community Center, who are sustaining us through these challenging times. And Amy, did you know MPA was even recognized this year with a tremendous $50,000 award from the National Endowment for the Arts?
Congratulations, Lori, to you and to all of you who are working to ensure MPA carries on long past COVID. We missed the benefit of our 2020 in-person fundraising events, so tonight's success is critical to our ability to continue the excellent mission-driven programming our community has come to expect from MPA.
Amy, you're right. One real benefit to this virtual format, however, is we're able to share examples tonight of our art and our mission-driven programming through the course of this next hour together. So while this benefit is different, as we can't greet one another in person, we can still bring that energy and enthusiasm to tonight's event.
Yes, we can. And we invite you to engage with us and with each other throughout the event by using the chat box, donating via the virtual platform, and actively bidding on our incredible and unique auction items.
This is so much fun. We are enjoying very much these auction items and getting to know a little bit more about MPA tonight. Before we begin the formal program, it's an honor to offer special thanks to our wonderful MPA Board Chair, Barbara Hawthorne, whose leadership and deep connection to the arts and diplomatic communities has enabled the incredible program we have for you tonight. Amy and I join Barbara in thanking our remarkable host committee, whose members shared their time and talents for this gala. And I share my special thanks with my colleagues who took on the event like a challenge that they were going to overtake from the beginning. Mm-hmm. Your commitment to excellence and teamwork brought this event to life.
We're delighted through the course of this evening to recognize our sponsors, starting with special recognition of Ray Kimsey and the Kimsey Foundation, and Matt Indre and Total Wine as presenting sponsors. Through our sponsors' generosity and your engagement, we know that tonight's event will be a tremendous success for MPA.
This evening is an opportunity to showcase the significance and impact of the arts by highlighting three core themes that are rooted in MPA's mission: how art springs community, how art springs inspiration, and our enduring theme,
ArtSprings Resilience.
Lori and I are excited to guide you through this event and can't wait to share performances by Joe Coleman and the voices of Classic Soul, as well as Ken Avis and Senator Tim Kaine with the Dave Kline Band. We'll also introduce live art featuring some of our exquisite community artists.
We begin our program close to home with two MPA artists whose careers are rooted with MPA. McLean natives and internationally celebrated painters, Antoinette Wysocki and Barbara Januszkiewicz.
Both Antoinette and Barbara will share their tremendous talent with us this evening, creating their works while we watch. We invite you to head to the silent auction down below to bid on what promises to be two stunning pieces, available only through tonight's event. Now let's learn more about both Antoinette and Barbara and check in on their paintings that are in progress.
Hi, I'm Antoinette Wysocki.
I'm Barbara Januszkiewicz.
My paintings are identified as abstract expressionistic.
My style is abstract expressionist.
And I'm excited to be part of McLean Project for the Arts Gala.
Barbara Januszkiewicz, it is so lovely to have time with you. I don't know if you know, but when I started my tenure at MPA, it was your exhibition that was the first on the wall. So I would love if you would rewind for us to your start with MPA.
That's very interesting. I was in third grade and I started taking classes at McLean Project of the Arts.
I never had an opportunity to take a class, but I did have my first exhibition, which was a big deal, I was so proud of, at the MPA.
In their location that was downtown, it was in the basement of the ballet school.
That was exciting because I remember my family coming. And
that experience stayed with me for the longest time. Being exposed to the elements of art and the wonderment of art was a treasure.
So I get to give that to MPA for my first taste and my first group show.
Well, fast forward for us. So where are you now?
So now I am in Westchester, New York.
I have a studio in Falls Church, Virginia.
I was very abstract starting out. So I made myself take botanical illustration at the Smithsonian. That was very influential in my work because I ended up really going in the direction where I involved a lot of different organic imagery in my work.
I've always been a big fan of Helen Frankenthaler's and Morris Lewis and the Washington Color School. I paint, and this is really what's called color field, but abstract thoughts. And I wanted to paint these huge color fields, but you know, I had won all these awards painting in this sort of pop art style. And an artist does not just change their style. I had to really venture out and experiment and make my own paints and my own tools. And now I'm engaged. I feel like I'm painting the sense of allness again.
People would say, like, I don't get it. I don't get the work. I don't understand abstract art. So then I started putting imagery that was somewhere embedded in the image that someone could identify. An invitation is kind of what I was doing for the viewer. The whole part of my work is process, right? It's all the layering. Instead of painstakingly trying to draw things all the time, I do these big collages. From there, we scan them, and then I work on top of it. Then I re-photograph it, have it re-scanned. So it has layers if I don't want to necessarily have texture.
What I'm doing, it took me years, almost 40 years, to have this ability to paint this way. And it gives me a sense of wonderment and possibilities that I could never have imagined otherwise.
Barbara, you have seen Washington's art scene grow. Can you comment a bit about what makes MPA unique?
That's a good question. I do feel it has to do with our mission statement. McLean Project of the Arts has been, as long as I can remember, a vehicle to attract anyone who wants to learn about art and see art.
The community presence of art is, you know, that's really important to me. And it's pretty fabulous to have this, you know, building right in McLean that's showing some serious artwork.
The more you're exposed to good art, the more you're going to develop an eye for it. And there is the place where McLean Project of the Arts starts from the beginning, with teaching classes for children, going right up to adults, to having a professional art gallery. It's a vehicle that needs to be cherished because it's not being done elsewhere.
Can you tell us a little bit about your work that you're painting for us?
I am going to be finishing my piece, The Night of the Gala.
Most of my artwork, big or small, takes me about 3 or 4 days. So the artwork that that's going to be shown at, you know, the auction brings the celebration of joy and happiness, which my artwork is all about.
I'm feeling very springy, trying to come out of this COVID. I want work to be very beautiful and that, you know, have this relaxing kind of pause, but some joy. As far as specific images, I'm not going to reveal that yet.
It is such a gift to have time with you tonight. We're thrilled as ever that you are exemplifying the mission of creating that safe space for art.
This gala, it is so wonderful because it is a celebration of what McLean Project of the Arts is all about. Your participation is so important that we want to make sure that we keep providing this for the next generation.
Thank you, McLean Project for the Arts. This is an amazing experience.
Wasn't that incredible? These are both tremendous stories and truly showcase the first theme of the gala, ArtSprings Community.
Amy, I am so excited by this celebration of creativity and of artistic contributions. And to continue the celebration, I'm pleased to introduce our next guest, the Honorable Hynek Kmoníček, Ambassador to the United States from the Czech Republic, who speaks eloquently to the importance of art. Being with us tonight is a natural fit for him, as in his words, his native country reveres art as the spiritual cradle of culture. He himself is an artist, beginning his career as a classical guitarist and continuing his artistic career as an exquisite chef. Please welcome Ambassador Hynek Kmoníček speaking on the role art has played throughout his international career in conversation with McLean resident and MPA supporter, Michelle Olson.
Ahoy, Yaksimash, Ambassador.
I am very well, and your Czech is really progressing because
you are
one of these hidden Czechs.
I am indeed. Thank you so much for joining us tonight for MPA's ArtSprings Gala. I'm so excited to be speaking with you about the role of art in forming community, and on a more macro scale, the role of art in forming democracy. I know you're a person of many talents, including cooking, music, and the arts. Can you tell us a little more about the roots of these passions for you?
So my connection with art started really from the very, very, very younger age. I think I gave my first concerto, surprisingly, on violin when I was like 4 years old. But I would not say it was my choice. It was the pure necessity. If you wanted to get to the West from the country behind the Iron Curtain, your only chance was to be ice hockey player or the classical musician. I couldn't be ice hockey player. I had to be a musician.
Can you tell us a little more about how you all transitioned from, you know, being artists to being politicians?
To be an artist is an exercise in how to be free. You cannot be non-free artist because art is an expression of your freedom. So when the Velvet Revolution came in November 1989, it was like a huge liberation for many people. And the artists, because they stayed free in their minds, were absolutely basic, elementary people the new regime turned into. because these were the people who still had the contacts with the West. These were the people who had dreams, and they had their own very deep feeling how the democracy and the connection between democracy, freedom, and art really works. So that's probably the one of the reasons why suddenly we had Václav Havel as a president who was not famous as a politician or diplomat, but as a person who writes his plays for theater, why half of our first parliament were artists and painters. And that's why we as the Czechs have now in the United States as their representative, a professional musician who spent half of his life playing Johann Sebastian Bach with symphonic orchestras around the world.
Tell us a little more about Prague, which through its museums and architectural treasures and collections really serves as an art mecca.
If I tell you that with 10 million people, we have a quarter of a million of children in the elementary art schools, that for 10 million people, we have 484 major museums with 343 other branches. And even in Prague, you ask me about for 1 million people, we have 268 galleries. So it opens the questions, do we ever work or we just are creating art for our galleries?
Well, we are so excited that one of tonight's auction items is a private dinner at your residence. Will you be cooking? Because if you are, I'm definitely bidding on it.
Well, Michelle knows, but I will share with the others. Every year there is a competition of the professional chefs for the ambassadors in the Washington area. But I was the only ambassador who competed against the chefs of the other ambassadors. So I think that if you are ready for the challenge, bet on the dinner, because I will definitely provide you with something very Czech. But I will also try to put on it a twist for people who are not afraid to push boundaries.
It sounds amazing. Ambassador, thank you so much for being with us this evening. You are such a pleasure to be around. I always enjoy my time with you. And MPA is grateful for your support and your kind auction item. Thank you.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
And now we are so honored to reveal a gift to MPA from McLean artist Emilie Benes Brzezinski and her family that will inspire our community for generations to come.
Amy, this gift illuminates both our first and second themes of the evening, how art springs community and inspiration. As the Brzezinski family are decades-long beloved members of our McLean community, MPA is so honored by and so very grateful for this priceless gift. We're eager for you all to know the details.
So to introduce this gift and kick off our second theme of the evening, Art Springs Inspiration, please join me in welcoming the eldest son of Emilie Benes Brzezinski, Ian Brzezinski.
Good evening. I'm Ian Brzezinski, speaking from what was once my family's home on Spring Hill Road here in McLean, Virginia. My parents, Emilie and Spigniew Brzezinski, raised my brother Mark, my sister Mika, and myself after moving to McLean in the mid-1970s. Last year, my mother moved to Florida to live closer to Mika and her husband Joe Scarborough. My family was thrilled to be able to work with the Fairfax County Park Authority and successfully chart a vision to preserve this wonderful property and the green space it offers the region. Today, I'm back at the property and here at the art studio where my brother, my sister, and I witnessed my mother doing one of her important callings in life, using her art to highlight the majesty and meaning of trees for the world. We count nearly 70 exhibitions of my mother's impressive and often massive work around the world. in Prague and Gdansk, in Dresden, in Warsaw and Budapest, in Cardiff, Wales, Henan and Kyoto, Florence and Negev, and in cities and campuses across North America. These, of course, include shows that she did with Nancy Saucer and the MPA as long ago as the 1980s. Given my family's deep respect for MPA's place in the region's art community, and my mother's longstanding relationship with the MPA, we are so happy that MPA has accepted her gift of many of her magnificent sculptures. We look forward to continuing, strengthening, and expanding this relationship by making MPA a new home for my mother's incredible artwork. The Brzezinski family is fired up to be working with MPA in furthering the essence and legacy of Emilie Benes Brzezinski's vision.
The revving of my mom's chainsaw was the soundtrack to my childhood. All while raising three children and being the partner to my father, that chainsaw did for her trees what my mom did for each of us. Build the story, the confidence, the strength, then bring out the beauty and value for all the world to see. Joe and I feel blessed that mom has chosen to come live near us in Florida. And my brothers, Mark and Ian, have also been enjoying her time in the sun. It's a gift to be with her at our respective ages. In watching her, I'm learning to play the long game. As at nearly 90, I see my mom's work still compels her. Her art drives her every day, and we are all awestruck by her gigantic pieces and inspired by her resilience.
It's very natural for one to do it because you cross-cut one in one direction, mm-hmm. and then you chip it in the other direction.
With a chainsaw?
No, you chip it actually with a mallet and a hammer.
And then which is coarse?
Well, this is one of them.
This is one of them. Okay.
Yeah.
It's huge.
These are these oblong shaped. They're not regular. They're crooked.
Right.
And that's why I picked them, because I happen to like things which have an unusual shape.
Beautiful, Mom.
Understanding the scope and the vision of Emilie Brzezinski requires us to start at the very beginning, in her own words.
I come from Czech Republic. I'm not Swiss, but I was born in Switzerland. During the war, we were in England, and I spent some time during the bombings in London, and then my school was evacuated to a place south of England. But we were lucky to escape the V2 bombs, and we went to California. This was like a paradise. My father used to take me on these huge trips up the Oregon coast, where there were beaches of washed up driftwood that we would pick through and find beautiful shapes, beautiful types of wood. And I used to make little carvings. Wood is a remarkable material because it has such inspiring forms in it. But you have to search it out. You have to find the extraordinary piece. And my aim is to not overdo, because I want the wood also to speak for itself.
And does it ever? Every person who's ever seen my mother's work is moved. From curators to collectors around the world to those who just walk by, they feel a connection and see what she sees, the secret shapes of trees, their movement, their story, their beauty. She doesn't carve the tree, she converses with it and follows the lines that she feels in the wood. My family and I are truly honored that McLean Project for the Arts has assumed the mantle to establish the next chapter of our mom's legacy. With MPA's deep knowledge of her work and their shared vision of the intersection of art and nature, we have confidence in how they will place this work and shepherd her vision.
Words are inadequate in expressing our thanks to Emilie and to the entire Brzezinski family. MPA is thrilled to accept this amazing gift, and we look forward to contributing to Emilie's legacy and to the immense value it provides to our growing community. I've asked my friend and colleague, Nancy Saucer, MPA Director of Exhibitions, to share more about Emilie's work and the significance of this gift.
Hello, I'm Nancy Saucer, MPA Exhibitions Director. I'm so happy to be adding my thanks to you, Emily, as well as to Ian, Mark, and Mika. Emily, I fondly recall working with you on our exhibition together and to visiting with you in your soaring studio space. Your work is a significant gift to MPA and our community, and we are excited to be able to work with your family, our colleagues, and the community to preserve and share the legacy of this work for years to come. MPA is particularly grateful to the Fairfax County Park Authority and their partnership in allowing us to access the sculptures in Emily's studio, now among the Fairfax County Park Authority's rich green spaces that they preserve for our region. To discuss Emily's work in more depth, I'm delighted to have had the opportunity to sit down with Milena Kalinowska. Milena has had a distinguished career as a curator and exhibitions director, first in London, then here in the States at the New Museum of Contemporary Art in New York, then the Institute of Contemporary Art in Boston, and most recently, the Hirshhorn here in DC. Since then, Milena has served as director of the Modern and Contemporary Art Collection at the National Gallery in Prague, and it's during her time there that she worked closely with Emily and best came to know her work. Here's just a minute or two of Milena's and my conversation, then back to Lori and Amy with the lights back on here at MPA's Emerson Gallery. Milena, thank you so much for joining us tonight.
Well, first of all, thank you so much for inviting me. It was a great pleasure to know Emilie Brzezinski. It was fascinating to go to her studio, looking at the variety of works that were all linked in a particular way. They were all surrounded around the notion of wood and nature. She never cut the wood, meaning a live wood. She would always collect dead wood. She had enormous respect for nature and its growth. To begin with, we could see abstract works. And then this all develops into, as you know, big wooden columns that were carved inside. And they were really almost like vessels for human expression. Emilie was very, very dedicated. This was a person, if you would meet anywhere, she would really question you seriously about some of her thinking. So I saw her as a very dynamic figure. Mm-hmm. When you meet her, you know, she was always in jeans and the shirt, her hair was tight at the back.
Ready to go.
And yes. I think in many ways, that was really who she was.
Thank you, Nancy and Milena, for deepening our appreciation of Emily's work. You know, Lori, one of the aspects of living in this region that I absolutely love is the opportunity to be friends and neighbors with world-renowned and remarkably accomplished individuals.
Amy, in that exact vein, it is now my pleasure to recognize even more of our wonderful hometown excellence by inviting Emily's children, Langley High School and Madeira graduates, Ian, Mark, and Mika Brzezinski, along with Ian's wife and Mika's co-author, Jenny Brzezinski, to share with us about their inspiring mother and this world-class gift for MPA.
Hi, I'm Mark Brzezinski, one of the children of Emily and Zbigniew Brzezinski.
Hi, I'm Ian Brzezinski.
I'm Jenny Brzezinski.
We're married.
And I'm Mika Brzezinski, I'm the youngest.
Well, I am delighted to be with you all today. It is so exciting for MPA to have received this spectacular gift. Ian and Mika, would you share a little bit about watching your mom work?
Well, the chainsaw was always going. And if it was not a chainsaw, it was an axe. And so we had a mom who we probably most remember her vividly wearing a huge like flight suit that zips up, covered with sawdust. And she would just walk around like that and that's run back to her studio and get to work.
She involved us in her art, whether we liked it or not, you know, teaching us to see things the way she did, to see things that people couldn't really identify at first glance and piece of wood or bark that she could bring out and highlight.
One of the most powerful pictures I saw of my mom's work was of her piece, which is on the river in Prague, Czech Republic. And the photo was of a blind man pressing up against that sculpture. And I said to myself, if a blind man can appreciate my mom's sculpture, then there's something special there.
Jenny, you and I have the same experience of walking in and appreciating the whole body of work. Can you talk a little bit about that?
Yeah, I think that Mark had talked about the blind man. And I think the other sense that is ignited by this artwork is your sense of smell. I mean, just inhaling how these pieces smell is incredible. To see a woman with a chainsaw doing the kind of things that she was doing and, you know, moving around these massive pieces, it was amazing.
I think she gave us a very strong picture of what it was like to be a woman who knew her value and was very, very proud of her identity as an artist. Sometimes the art came first, sometimes the husband came first, and sometimes, you know, the husband in the White House came first, and sometimes we came first, but you know what? We weren't always first. Yeah. And it taught us an important lesson.
Our father was a scholar. He was a strategist. He was a policy expert and an expert on foreign affairs. And he was married to an artist working on wood with a chainsaw. A unlikely pairing, perhaps, but they both fed on each other's intellectual strengths and benefited tremendously.
I remember your father, I don't know if he did it on all her pieces, but he pointed out to me on several of them where he had surreptitiously like made some little carving. He'd be like, that.
That's really fun.
And that's what made it great.
There's anecdotes that I don't know if you all want to tell that I have heard that are just delightfully funny. I know we're not to tell the roadkill story, right, Mika?
Oh, no, roadkill? Why not? Are we not allowed?
You said that in an interview one.
No, my mom.
Politics and prose.
Ian, roadkill story, go.
My mother is from Central Europe. She's a refugee. She had a deep love for venison. And that deep love.
Fresh venison.
Especially fresh venison. And that deep love led her to see opportunity in what other people would call roadkill. One day on Old Dominion, for those who live in McLean will know Old Dominion, all right, by the house, she came across a deer that had been hit that night. That was on a Saturday. And on a Sunday, my parents were hosting an ambassadorial dinner, or luncheon, serving venison medallions. And it was Averill Harriman and his wife, Pamela Harriman. And so they were eating there and they asked, this is fantastic meat. What is it? My father probably said, it's venison. They go, oh my gosh, so where did you shoot it? And so my father, shoot it. Mushka found it on the road yesterday. And poor Mrs. Averill Harriman literally spit out her meat on the table. My father looked at her and goes, oh, don't worry. It was hit by a very, very expensive Mercedes. It's good to go.
Unbelievable.
But Laura, let me focus on the gift that my mother's giving to the MPA, because it really reflects the relationship she had with your organization and the art community in the region, which she felt very much a part of. And what we're so excited about, what she's excited about, is the ability to leverage, so to speak, her art so that not only can it be preserved, but it can also be used to inspire people to become interested in art, maybe to become artists.
This is probably one of the most meaningful things we'll do together as a family. And I think that Dad would be so proud of us right now. And this is exactly what he would want. I think that honoring her work and finding a place for it to be delivered and for people to see and for it to have exposure in different ways, through MPA, oh my gosh, he would just be so, so happy. He'd be overjoyed.
This to me is a dream come true.
Yeah.
Two central beautiful things in my life. Spring Hill and my mom are being preserved. And Ian and Jenny did the heavy lifting. And I'm grateful for that. And I'm grateful to Fairfax County Park Authority and MPA for working so collaboratively to give to the people of McLean, Fairfax County, Virginia, the United States and the world, this remarkable gift. You will be impressed when you see it.
MPA is thrilled. I am honored on behalf of our board, our advisory board and our staff to accept this exceptional gift. Thank you all so very much.
Thank you.
Thank you, Lori, so much.
Ian, Mark, Mika, Jenny, thank you all. This gift is such a dynamic example of how generosity can advance and transform our organization to inspire others on countless fronts. And this family is so much fun. It's a perfect time now to remind everyone too that just by scrolling down below Amy's and my video, you'll find opportunities to make your own generous gifts through either bidding on our exciting auction items or by making mission-based donations at any level.
You're right, Lori. I like that. Now, can you tell us a little bit more about mission-based donations?
Oh, absolutely, Amy. We cannot stress enough the importance of your support for MPA for our community. And tonight, your donations will go straight to our outreach programs. For example, your gifts could fund art supplies for the outreach programs we run for special needs students, or provide scholarships for students in our summer camps, or even underwrite the filming and production of our instructional videos with ArtReach director Sharon Fischel.
So all that's available through the donations below, and we invite you to do so now. Now for your enjoyment and while you're exploring those mission-based donation needs, which I love by the way, I am so pleased to present a very special opportunity to hear from esteemed musician and NPA board member Joe Coleman. Joe has joined with other Motown greats in forming a new group, Voices of Classic Soul, who will bring us to our feet with an exclusive performance of the classic Can't Help Myself.
Sugar pie, honey bun, sugar
appreciated Joe and the voices of classic soul. Lori and I were grooving away back here the whole time, and I know that you have seen her on the dance floor. Thankfully, that was not the only performance by voices of classic soul of the night, as we look forward to seeing them again later. We will also hear from Ken Avis and the Dave Kline Band with special guest Senator Tim Kaine on harmonica as they close out the evening with a special benefit concert.
Amy, in the meantime, let's check in on the progress of our artists, Antoinette and Barbara.
Okay, so here we are. And I'm going to sign it and take off the tape. But I wanted to give you some detailed shots to see if this is something that you would like to own.
Okay, this is it, the very last brush stroke. Voila, enjoy.
Wonderful. And let me remind everybody to head over to our silent auction and place your bids on these works and our other auction items. Also, we're just minutes away from the big donation event of the evening. We encourage you to participate and make your donation so we can ensure tonight's gala is a success. But first, it is my pleasure to introduce the third and final theme of the evening, ArtSprings Resilience.
Amy, resiliency is top of mind these days as individuals, businesses, nonprofits, and certainly the arts continue to transform and navigate our way back from the global pandemic. Within days of the shelter-in-place mandates placed last spring, MPA responded. Without missing a beat, our arts faculty transformed their teaching into virtual studios and carried on with our arts instruction online. MPA's exhibitions also quickly and successfully launched virtually, demonstrating the centrality of art and creativity in building resilience in us individually and in our communities. Through the course of this past difficult year, art truly proved to be a source of inspiration for many, and clearly, MPA became a community of thousands. You know, Amy, the number of artists who applied for our exhibitions and the number of art lovers attending our virtual openings increased by 200%. And that remarkable growth was dwarfed by the 500% increase in lives we touched through MPA's signature outreach program, MPA ArtReach. I could not be more proud nor more grateful for how we've worked together through the pandemic.
Wow is all I can say to that. Wow, wow, wow. Art truly does spring resilience. It's thanks to the ingenuity and commitment of you, Lori, and the entire NPA team, as well as the incredible support of our artists and community, that NPA continue to make such an incredible impact.
To share more about resilience, here's a snapshot of how the amazing team at NPA and our partners work together to support our community. MPA ArtReach creates an environment that builds conversation. It builds conversation between people who don't know each other yet or don't know yet that part of themselves that finds real connection through art.
I've taught for so many years in many different capacities. And one of the things about the ArtReach program is our ability to be flexible.
Some people thrive off like concrete directions, step by step. Here's a template, you know, follow every step.
Oh yeah, look at that.
Then other people we've learned like take it and run, and just showing us a little part of themselves, I think definitely has helped them to persevere.
When things grow as you're teaching, it gives you the sense that there's something profoundly moving, driving it.
Is that Miss Meg who just signed on? Getting to log in for an hour for art once a week with her friends and with Sharon think it's a great way for some of our individuals to communicate and, of course, getting to use their creativity and to express themselves. And they absolutely just love it.
Everybody feels connected at their own level. That, for me, fundamentally is the most rewarding part. And I think that that's what has really kept this group so uplifting.
It has been a remarkable year in so many ways, and we are honored to continue our outreach in the community. You've just heard about the great work of our ArtReach program, continuing to serve and grow thanks to the enterprising leadership of our ArtReach director, Sharon Fischel. Sharon's close work with our ArtReach partners has meant that despite the constraints placed on the arts outreach by this pandemic, we have made and been able to continue the support of our community and provide art as a means of enrichment and learning to people of all ages. One of our most valued ArtReach partnerships is with Service Source, whose long-term relationship and weekly ArtReach classes make them one of our primary program partners. I am so pleased to be joined now by Kenneth Crum, Executive Vice President and Head of Regional Operations of Service Source, Incorporated, who will join Lori in a deeper dive into our partnership.
Well, my name is Ken Crum.
My name is Lisa Ward.
I am the Executive Vice President of Regional Operations, overseeing Service Source's Virginia programs.
I am the Executive Director of the Service Source Foundation.
Our mission is to support really our community, which includes a wide array of persons served, individuals with developmental disabilities, older adults, veterans, folks with mental health support needs, creating opportunities for our folks to be active members in their community and to do so right alongside other community members is exactly what we're all about. And so the partnership with MPA has helped facilitate that.
I think art is really something that transcends all abilities, all interests. And so our folks have really, you know, they've learned these new skills. One of the things Ken talked about was the inclusion.
You know, that last 5-10 minutes of the class where folks get to share what they created during those classes is the most supportive and wonderful time of the session.
I was actually told of a recent experience where one of our individuals, her name is Meg, and you know, she has a big life event coming up. She's anticipating a move into a group home. And in that day's art class, they were talking about making model homes. And so just what was done in that art class, talking about homes and what goes into a home, and that really helped her and feeling more comfortable in her decision to be able to move into a group home.
So we've really seen a lot of wonderful outcomes from this, where folks who use the opportunity of the MPA classes and learning opportunities to really grow in those experiences. And they've shared some wonderful stories about how it's impacted their lives. And that wouldn't have been possible without the partnership with MPA.
Those are the programs that kind of go above and beyond. And so it's critical with our donors, both to MPA and to the Service Source Foundation, that with their support, we're able to add some of these really life-enriching programs. And that's really the best way I can describe it. You know, when people with disabilities are thriving in the community and providing back, and McLean Project for the Arts is supporting that effort, and we're supporting you, the whole entire community wins. You know, you just never realize as a donor just what the ripple effect is of that donation that you make that supports the programs.
Lori, we're thankful for you and Sharon and the whole MPA team and all the work and effort that you have helped in developing such a wonderful partnership over the years. And we look forward to, you know, what's coming in the short term and in the long term for MPA and Service Source as a team.
If I can,
I do.
Teresa, can you tell me?
That would be kind of hard on Zoom.
Thank you, Ken and Lisa, for sharing the important work you do with so many members of our community. MPA is proud to partner with you. What an authentic look at the return on investment we are able to offer the community. This is all powered by the generosity of MPA's donors and partners. Right, Lori?
Amy, you are exactly right. Each year, MPA touches the lives of more than 25,000 people across the region. And Lori, of course, this is really meaningful and heartfelt work that you and MPA do. Of course, none of this would be possible without the generosity of the MPA community. All year, we've been reading about the difficulties of sustaining a nonprofit. But with this remarkable and essential community support, NPA continues to thrive. Amy, working with art teaches all of us to be creative problem solvers. ArtSprings tonight is a terrific example. I thank our partners and I compliment my colleagues for their creative approach to producing this fun and informative night celebrating our monumental gift from Emilie Benes Brzezinski, along with MPA's many contributions in the community. To support MPA's work, our team has identified areas where we need help at a wide variety of giving levels. A $25 gift tonight will buy art supplies for our outreach program about which you heard so much earlier. A $250 gift will fund a scholarship student for our MPA summer camp. Your gift of $2,500 will make a big difference in our legacy building work with Emilie Brzezinski's spectacular sculptures. And we would love if tonight were to inspire a $10,000 gift from a donor who would like to underwrite our next exhibition. Just as it has been for the six decades of our history, every gift counts.
Every gift indeed counts. And I love how there are so many ways to make a difference at every level. All you need to do is donate now by using the donate button on your screen. And to give you just a little bit of time to check in on your auction bids and see where you stand, we're going to make, you know, of course, one last donation. We are so pleased to once again be inspired by Joe Coleman and the voices of classic soul, because only you can put us over the top tonight.
Only you can the make of this world seem like only you can the make the darkness bright.
Destiny. Thank you, dear Joe. You are a treasure. And hi, I'm Barbara Hawthorne, chair of the MPA board. And with me this evening is fellow board member and very talented Ken Avis.
Hi, Barbara. It's a great pleasure to be here. It's a great pleasure to be part of MPA and part of this community. I started working with MPA a few years ago doing the music for Art Fest. And since then, I've now joined the board and have a pleasure of being involved in so many of the activities that are done for the community. And it's a big thank you to you, the community, for being here tonight and for contributing so much energy and money, please, as well. We could do with a little bit of money. It always helps.
And on behalf of the MPA board, we share our gratitude with our community and the whole team at MPA who has made this possible. This evening is a success because of the incredible participation, including a heartfelt thank you to Ambassador Kmoníček and to the Brzezinski family. We are incredibly grateful for the opportunity to be here and to make a difference throughout our community. I want to also thank our host committee and our sponsors who have made this evening possible and has continued to support so many of our programs which have been so vital throughout this very unusual year. And to those who continue to bid, I want to encourage you to bid on our two live artists' works, Barbara and Antoinette, and to also continue bidding on our auction items and those very important mission-oriented donations for art supplies, for outreach, filming for our outreach classes, and so many other items that would not be possible without your support.
Yeah, I mean, it's wonderful that people are staying with us and stay with us a little longer because we have more to show and more opportunities for people to become involved. You were talking about the year and what a challenge the year has been. And what's impressed me so much about MPA this year is despite the challenges of the pandemic, there's been innovation all the time. I mean, just around us here in this gallery, they found ways to innovate and to continue putting on gallery shows and doing it by live stream and by bringing people in one or two at a time. Another innovation coming up soon is the first ever Art Smash, which is organized by Catherine Powell and Jackie Henry. And that's going to be a COVID-safe tennis event, May the 14th, May the 15th. There are tickets available now on the MPA website, so get over there. And this is something to be involved in, a chance to get out and be with friends and community again and enjoy this great event while supporting the community. Just so many innovations. And one thing I'm hoping we get back this year is going to be the October Art Fest.
Yes.
I love the Art
that
Fest.
That is brilliant. And as usual, MPA will do its best to really provide the entire community what they need, whether they are still staying at home and prefer virtual, or they feel comfortable to be on site and celebrate in the great outdoors.
Another opportunity for folks as well tonight is we've not finished the show. There's going to be some more music before the end of the show. And we have a very, very special guest. We have Senator Tim Kaine, a longtime friend of MPA, performing live on harmonica and vocals with the Dave Kline Band, an Art Fest performer. So that's coming up at the end of the show. And do stay involved for that one and keep on putting those donations in. And now it's over to Amy and to Laurie to show some more of this fabulous art.
Thank you, Barbara and Ken. And yes, Ken, my family and I love Art Fest too. Sunday, October 3rd is already on my calendar. And Lori, before we conclude our portion of this evening, let's take a minute to highlight our incredible style. We are so honored that Max Mara reached out to NPA to become our exclusive fashion sponsor for 2021. We thank them for dressing us from head to toe in their spring collection. And by the way, what was it that you said you're doing tomorrow?
Ooh, Amy, I am so excited that Barbara Hawthorne and I will be at the Max Mara store tomorrow at 1 p.m. We're going to be in the Galleria. They have offered us a 10% discount, and they're sharing another 10% of the proceeds from our sales between now and May 6th back to MPA. So I encourage all of us together to affirm our sponsors and visit Max Mara this week.
Now, Laura, we also want to thank David Yerman for supporting NPA again this year. The wonderful Allison Waldrop, the market manager for David Yerman, came here to NPA's galleries to accessorize us from pieces from their origami and novella collections. And they gave the classic David Yerman cable bracelet for tonight's auction.
Amy, the auction will close at 9:30 p.m. and just thereafter, the winners will be contacted by email. There's still time tonight to support MPA throughout our last performance of the evening, while Ken Abus and the Dave Kline Band, with special guest and former Spring Benefit honoree, Senator Tim Kaine, will be playing in benefit for MPA.
Well, it has been a joy for us to host tonight, and it's been an incredible celebration of the arts this evening. We know your generous donations will continue to uplift and support MPA's work. What a terrific first ever virtual gala. So what do you think, Lori? What are the numbers?
Amy, I'm really excited. We're getting close. So far, in addition to what you're seeing on the thermometer on your screen, the auction monies that are coming in, we are at $130,000 against our $150,000 goal.
Amazing.
We would like to end this evening by thanking our presenting sponsors, the Kimsey Foundation and Total Wine and More. Ray Kimsey, a filmmaker, has been instrumental in helping us get going on our first ever virtual gala. And Total Wine and More, we so appreciate your material gifts to MPA. And Matt and Dre, your partnership means the world. We've loved you getting to know our ArtSprings partners, Ambassador Kmoníček, Melina Kalinowska, Ked Krum, Lisa Ward, and Teresa Piccolo of ServiceSource. And to the entire Brzezinski family, we thank you for this gift. We thank you for the gift of your friendship. And yes, Ian, we are fired up about all there is ahead.
We again thank Barbara Hathorne, our host committee and sponsors, along with our board and community businesses who helped us put on this terrific silent auction. Finally, we thank MPA's board and advisory board members who created the very special donor thank you gifts. It is through this collective generosity that we can move MPA forward while keeping the personal touch and act of kindness that defines this community.
Amy, we spoke earlier about the idea of hometown excellence. And it is really an honor for me to let you all know that Amy and I have known each other since about when Mrs. Brzezinski had her first exhibition. We had her first exhibition here in the gallery. And you are an example of hometown excellence. I encourage you all to find Amy on Instagram if you're not already following her, to look for her segments on TV, to enjoy her books. And we enjoy your friendship so much. Thank you for this time.
I truly appreciate it. It has been a complete honor to be here with you and with everybody who is watching. Thank you for your generous donations. If anything, I am a product of the arts. So in complimenting me, full circle back to you, Lori. Thank you for all the work that you do to keep the glue of MPA together.
Oh, hold on. Well, thank you for that. And before I blush and cry, I want to stop and recognize that Mrs. Brzezinski is watching us this evening. And it is wonderful to know that you and Mika with your dogs are enjoying this show so much tonight. I've not yet had the chance to meet you, but transitive property of motherhood, I'm going to say by knowing your children, your warmth radiates through them and your inspiration through your work. It's a blessing to be in the presence of your artwork in your studio and to get to know your children. I so look forward to getting to know you.
What a way to conclude. My goodness. Thank you so much, everyone. Stick around for our closing benefit concert and don't forget to click and donate to NPA.
Please do help put us over that goal tonight. It'll mean the world.
Thank you.
And good night.
And good night.